Yep.
We've got one person being arrested here. We're good. Yep. Hold on. I got you. Hold on. They had us here. We're speaking with State Patrol right now. Give us a second, guys. We can move back to where you'd like. We can move back to where you'd like here. We are live on the air at the moment. This is the four of us. We are one team. Just put us back where you want us. We are getting out of your way, so. And this is a scene here playing out in Minneapolis. This is part of the advanced police presence that we saw come over the course of really minutes when the local police showed up at the fire department, or with the fire department, I should say, on that building we showed you that was burning. This is among the State Patrol unit that was advancing up the street, saying and scattering the protesters at that point for people to clear the area. And so we walked away. I'm sorry?
You're under arrest.
Okay. Do you mind telling me why I'm under arrest, sir? Why am I under arrest, sir?
Officer, you're with CNN, and he's on the air right now. I'm here with CNN. You are arresting him live on CNN. We told you before that we are with CNN.
I'm about there, guys. We were just out here reporting the closure of the streets. They just Omar was just arrested. I believe they're about to we're all about to be arrested. That's our producer. I'm probably going to be taken in a minute. We were just, like I said, just reporting on the closure. Why, guys, why are you arresting us? We're just passing along the message, your message. And, you know, we're just out here doing our job as well as you are.
We can do that.
Can you tell me what are...
Are you under arrest?
Okay. I'm being arrested now. I gotta put, can I put the camera down?
Omar Jimenez has been released after being arrested for simply doing his job, and he is with us this morning. Good morning, Omar. Thank you for trying to do your job through all of that, to you and your crew. As you sit with this now, what are your reflections of what happened?
Well, there's a lot I've been thinking about. One, how surreal the experience actually was. I think just talking to some other people now, you get in this reporting mode, obviously, where you're talking about what's happening all around you, but it's you don't want it to be the case where you actually become the story and you get involved in it. But then when things began to shift, you had to turn off that reporter mode at least a little bit and become a literal human who was being arrested by the police in the midst of a story where the police are under criticism for how they are dealing with the public. And as we were sitting in the back of the van being transported to the public safety building, being transported downtown, we're cuffed in the back. A lot of thoughts went through my mind. I thought of my grandmother, who had been arrested when she was marching in the civil rights movement, and she had been arrested multiple times. When I called her, she jokingly welcomed me to the club. And then also I thought about my mom when I called her afterwards. I felt my phone, or I heard it, I should say, vibrating because it was in a separate bag going off. And when I called her, her biggest fear was that she was trying to track down where I was, but I wasn't booked into the system, so she had no idea. All she knew was that I was arrested and that in her mind I had disappeared. And the other thing that comes to mind is, as we've been analyzing how this story has affected communities across the country, particularly in the Black community, there's one message that I think sticks out, and that when people say, oh, things are getting so much worse, how could things be this bad? Partly that, but also it's not that it's getting worse, it's that it's getting filmed. And I think when the fact that this played out live on television, the account was very clear as to what happened. There was no doubt as to what happened. You saw it, I lived it, the audience saw it, as opposed to so many situations where there is no camera. Yeah. And accounts get called into question.
Also arrested along with you, don't have to remind you, Leonel Mendez, a U.S. Army veteran, we should note, and Bill Kirkos, arrested and handcuffed, all for doing your job. The Minnesota State Patrol has not apologized for this. In fact, they put out a misleading tweet to explain your arrest, saying the three were released once they were confirmed to be members of the media. Now, to get at the just utter absurdity of this supposed explanation, we just want to play a clip of you repeatedly identifying yourself as journalists, showing your credentials, not to mention the fact you were live on the air as it happened, and then I want to get your reaction to that. Let's play it for our viewers.
Okay. Do you mind telling me why I'm under arrest, sir? Why am I under arrest, sir?
Officers, we're with CNN, and he's on the air right now.
And before, we should note to viewers who may not have seen it, he showed his press credentials to those same officers. Did you get an explanation while you were being detained as to why then you were held?
I never really got a clear explanation in the moment as to why we were being detained, why cuffs were being put on us. All the arresting officer told me is that he was following orders from whom I do not know, and I don't know that I will know at any point. Our crew, as you mentioned as well, I definitely want to shout them out because they also were in this with me, and they handled it with grace as well. You saw the camera and you heard the voice of Leonel Mendez, our photographer, and this was really a team thing. We stuck together here, but it definitely was a very surreal moment, going from doing your job to in the back of a van being transported downtown.
Yeah. Yep. Not what we expect in this country, and yet it happened. Omar Jimenez, thanks so much. We're glad you're safe.
Yeah.
Well, President Trump escalating the already sky-high tensions in Minnesota with a tweet that forced Twitter to do something it has never done before with a presidential tweet. You'll want to see this. We'll be right back.